Cup games in this country in 2000, including England against Ireland in the quarterfinals and England against New Zealand in the semi-finals. And we all know, of course, on that day, New Zealand wiped the floor with the English. But the English tonight, the English boys, the England A team, they are watching in their hotel in Lancashire ahead of tomorrow when they have their big day against the French. Good evening to John Keir, Paul Cullen and his boys. Welcome to the Kingston upon Hull Stadium. And we're underway for the second test. The ball went backwards through Deacon's legs. Fortunately for Great Britain, fortunately for Paul Deacon.
What a big let off there. Didn't get a right contact with the pair of hands there. That really could have been a negative start. Interesting to think that at least we won the toss. We didn't kick off. At least Adrian Bawley will go past the 12 seconds.
Well, I think he'll last a little bit longer than that.
80 minutes, I hope.
Indeed so. And here is Stuart Fielden, one of the giants of Wigan last week for Great Britain's cause. Made 40 metres this set of six, Deacon. Shuttles it wide to Farrell. Oh, and that's charged down. It's charged down and Radlinski slips! And the Australians have it back with Badiris.
Very slow with the kick, Andy Farrell. They're in all sorts of trouble at Great Britain.
This is Michael de Veer, and they're offside on the far side, Great Britain.
He warned them. I said they were very slow. The crowd don't like it. Australian referee has picked it up, but it's a relieved skipper, Andy Farrell, that knows that they could have conceded 6 points. It was charged down. He was very slow to get it away.
It bounced off the head of de Veer almost. He almost turned his back.
And Chris Radlinski went into the game, went to try to get the ball, and his feet just slipped underneath him.
Frank.
Boy, this Frank. Is a huge let-off for the Great Britain Frank. Boys.
Well, I'm not so sure about that, Steve, because Fitzgibbon will slot this over, I fancy. He's a goal kicker of great quality.
It could have been six.
Can you hear me?
Quite obvious there on the right-hand side. Yeah, Paul Scunthorpe was the main culprit. Made no effort to get back the 10. David Way, obviously more relieved. He knows it could have been 6-0. Never mind the two.
Well, it was a near fatal slip by Chris Radlinski. It was not the best kick from Andrew Farrell. And here is Craig Fitzgibbon. 3 from 3 last week. This is his first attempt, and listen to the crowd. It's hit the post and found its way over. He breathes a sigh of relief, and Australia are 2 up. Well, the crowd did their best. It hit it full on the face of the post, but it still managed to find its way over the top of the bar. Fitzgibbon's boot. Great Britain 0, Australia 2. And Deacon restarts. Oh, and that's a big error. Gower lifted for Cairns, and the ball bounced. And bounced dead. Dropout underneath the Australian sticks.
Well, remember, it was Gower that came up with the error exactly in the similar situation. After he just scored, remember when it was a little halfback, Brett Kamali put in a beautiful pass to put Gower there. He was basking in the glory on that moment, knocked on. Nerves had affected all the players.
Underneath the dropout was Radlinski, and here comes Fielden again. Now Barry McDermott, the lead's brought forward. David Waite will be looking for a big 20 minutes, half an hour from him. It's with the captain. He shuttles it on to Adrian Morley.
Interesting to see Andy Farrell has been utilised right out wide in the centres. A lot of the time last week, he was positioned on the inside. He's obviously a lot fitter for this game.
Deacon gets the ball in field. It's Peacock now for Great Britain, but he's enveloped by four green and gold jerseys. Plays the ball to Newton. Newton to Farrell, who slides the kick through. It bounces kindly. Morley flicks it. This could be a try for Terry Newton.
It is
a try. Brilliant pass off the deck. What a pass off the deck. And Terry Newton comes up with a try. And it was Adrian Morley who got got the pass away. Britain respond.
Was it ever? What a superb piece of play. He was going down, knew he couldn't reach for the line, and just flipped it up with the right hand. What a pass, but what a wonderful weighted kick from Andy Farrell. He came up with the mistake, remember, a few moments ago when he was charged down. This is the error from Gower. No communication between the two Australian players. They expected a full kick towards the fullback. It bounced right. Look at that pass. Maybe 50-50 when you show it a little bit slower. But how quick thinking was that? Great support by Newton. See from the side angle, it'll be a lot clearer. Yeah, that looked all right. What a start after the shaky beginning by the Great Britain boys. Terry Newton has set this crowd absolutely alight.
And now Deacon, such a regular and reputed kicker in Super League, and he carries that form with him to the Test Arena. And Great Britain are ahead by 6-2. And Terry Newton's try, they have responded to that Fitzgibbon goal in the best possible manner.
Well, what a mistake from the kickoff from Gower that allowed Great Britain the possession to put the power play on there. And it was a beautiful little kick, wasn't it? Look at that pass. Newton just trailing on the inside. Wow.
McDermott with another drive forward. Newton, the try scorer, gets the ball away. And here comes Fielden. Fierce challenges from the Australian defence, led by Robbie Cairns. Australia stung. Sculthorpe, good ball. Peacock, the man of steel. Well, this second Think Road Safety Test, an explosive start, just as we did last week, but for totally different reasons. Farrell takes the fourth tackle.
As I mentioned, Eddie, it was a very shaky start by Great Britain, but they've come back, and that's the kicking game we were talking about, and that's a shame.
Knocked on by Radlinski.
They've been working hard in that kicking game. Australia expecting the long kick downfield. It was the same with Farrell, the little short grubber that created the try.
Twice, Steve-O, we've seen Radlinski slip. Almost crucially, nearly conceded a try, and there he slipped as he went for the little kick through.
It's obviously he's got the very short studs.
This is a very lush surface, though, here. Well, that's a big hit by Fielden on Steve Simpson.
It's been very dry all through the day and windy, so therefore, I can't really think that there's a lot of dampness out on the field of play.
Webke just bounced off the challenge then from Morley. They are 30 metres away, Australia, with Badouris to Kim Morley. Back this way it comes again, but good defence once more from Great Britain to repel Cairns. That's a great pass to Ricketson.
Good tackle there by McDermott. Super low tackle on the loose forward. It had to be as well.
Kim Morley with a dab to the in-goal area. And it's just knocked dead. Oh, the referee wants a look. He wants to hand this on to the video referee to take a look. Just wants to check whether Fitzgibbon got a hand on it.
Well, I think he just wants to sort out how to restart this game. It bobbled all over the place, didn't it? Oh, it's a good job that Deacon's Booth got there. Just got there in time. Wow. That was ever so close.
Well, Ian Ollerton is tonight's video referee here for the second test.
There'll be no try.
No try. Goal line dropout. Fitzgibbon was hunting, though, and interestingly enough, we mentioned the boots and the studs. There's Chris Anderson, the Aussie coach. We mentioned the boots and the studs of Chris Radlinski. He is having a change of boot in the in-goal area.
Let's go, Paul. No, we don't wait for that.
So, two slips, enough for Radlinski. He's called for a change of footwear. The Aussies will come back, though, second set of six. Here is Robbie Cairns, and that is Newton and Peacock. They bring him down.
You see Great Britain, they've obviously been working this week on the fact they're trying to turtle the Australians.
Badouris, good run.
Pretty slow in the first and second marker area there, but getting back to that defence for Great Britain, they're trying to turn the Australians to stop them, prevent them from a quick play of the ball.
How about that, though, for a run from Craig Wing? They're camped under the sticks. This is Kim Morley, great ball back to Ricketson. and Ricketson was almost through. Farrell got a grab on him and pulled him down with help from Radlinski. Australia under the British sticks. Tim Hawley, great ball to Gower. Gower runs straight into Newton.
Great
ball, last tackle.
Wonderful ball and all tackle there, and you can see they're trying to flip them back over yet again.
Here's Kimoli, another stab kick through. That's for Lockyer. That's a try. That's a try.
No doubt about it.
Brilliant, Kimoli and Lockyer. The 1-2 that caused so much damage at Wigan late last week. And Lockyer with the try. And Britain have got to stop Kimoli.
Well, this kid has not trained all week. He had a light run yesterday. He has not been included in any heavy work whatsoever. No doubt about the onside. The kick from the architect yet again, the halfback Brett Kimoli. I remember saying after the game when Australia took Wales apart, I said I would like to send Kimoli on a 3 weeks holiday to Lanzarote. Fully paid. I wish you'd have taken the offer because he's superb.
Fitzgibbon adds the extras and Australia are 8-6 ahead. Well, we had 80 minutes at Wigan and we've had around about 10 minutes or so here. And surely David Waite will get the message out. Lockyer is a danger man, but the key is Kimoli, and somehow Great Britain have got to stop him.
The only trouble is, Eddie, is that he's so adept with both the kick and the pass. Remember, they hesitated last weekend, expecting Kimoli to get the kick away. He threw the dummy, shut the pass down, and Gower scored. He's a very creative player. It's hard to shut him down.
Yes, he's filling the boots of Andrew Johns, and it's as though the Australians aren't really missing him. And Andrew Johns is a magician. But Kimoli is not much behind him. Oh, here's the break on. Terrific break here from Australia. And it's the winger, Matt Singh, gets to within 30 metres. Lockyer with another kick over the top. Deacon, he's on the light whitewash with his foot. It'll be head and feet at the scrum here to the Australians.
Kicking early in the tackle count. Trying to catch the Great Britain defence. Great tactics. That was poor defence, Matt Singh. They went high on him, they've got to go low. He kept his cool. That was good play by the winger. He knew that possession was vital. And they were quick to play the ball. There was only Radlinski there. You can see that Great Britain was struggling. They hesitated, they didn't get into his face, and they may pay the price.
Gower, tackled by Senior and Radlinski. Camped under the sticks again, Vadiris. This is Fitzgibbon.
We've got to get out of the blocks a bit quicker than that. We've got to put the pressure on them. We're allowing them to dictate.
Vadiris again. And Webke was tackled surely by Farrell.
Well, that should be a penalty. He hit the deck. Tim Mander, the referee, says play on.
And that's why they're in possession here with, once again, Craig Wing. Can Great Britain survive this set of six? Kimoli. Wide ball, Lockyer, big hole for Lockyer to dab the ball into. I think that's over the line.
It certainly is.
That's over the line.
Good effort though by Minicello.
Oh, the referee wants another look.
Well, he hasn't got it, I can assure you. It's in the whitewash first. Not much in it, but the official, he may as well use the video. Nothing wrong with the video screen to make sure. No doubt in my mind or anybody's mind that this will be NOTRY. But again, the kicking game, the short one, we saw it superbly played by Farrell. Now it's the Australians that are utilising it.
Now here's McDermott again. 6-8 down, Great Britain. 12, 13 minutes almost of the test match gone. In possession here with Sculthorpe. And Sculthorpe looking to offload and does to Gary Connolly. Brian Carney, the hero of Wigan, and of course a former Hull player. But he never played on this ground. Not in the black and white of Hull anyway. Newton offloads. This is Fielden. Great ball round the corner, Deacon! Deacon! He has got Richard. Richard Horton in, but he takes the tackle from Lockyer. A brilliant one it was too.
He was running out of steam, did the right thing, made sure of possession. Got to get it wide if we can.
Farrell skips away, gets the ball infield to Radlinski. Radlinski then back to Paul Sculthorpe. Sculthorpe onto Newton, quick hands then to Deakin. Here is Keith Senior. Paul's got inside it. Senior! Great run from Senior. It's 2 metres short on the last. Newton with a kick. Not a bad kick either, but just running, getting goal. Oh, and a nasty tumble.
Craig Gower, he'll bring them back. Not really, we didn't need that. Craig Gower, the ball had already gone dead, and Craig Gower was just trying to get a void. He watched the push here. Just a little bit too strong, a bit of panic there. Not the best from Stuart Fielden. Said it's all right, they'll take the tap.
David Waite just had a word with Stuart Fielden, then said it's not necessary.
But what a wonderful break there by Deakin, and what about the pass from Stuart Fielden? That was world class.
Talking of world class, he's one of the best front rowers in the world, Shane Webke. Well, Great Britain 5-2 ahead in the offloads, but behind on the scoreboard where it matters.
Two.
Remember, July 2002, Australia beat Great Britain 64-10. They're now aiming to wrap up a 10th consecutive series win in this country. Another kick through. And Richard Hall, the hero of Hull. Can he be the hero of Great Britain? Tries to break the line.
Had a wonderful game last week.
So did this fellow, Carney. Let's go down after a quarter of an hour to Sean McRae. It's not a bad test again, Sean.
No, it's a great start by both sides, Eddie. I think what's obvious from 7 days ago is the willingness of the Great Britain players to play the ball just that little bit quicker, and also their desire to offload. I guess when you're down 1-0 in a best of three series, you must take the attack to the other team. There's a break now of Keith Senior. I think I'll let it go back to you, Eddie.
Well, Senior, I'm afraid the pass wasn't the best. He passes one-handed, Steve-O.
I know, it's but if you get away with it, you're the hero, Eddie. And they just make the wonderful break. It just shows that, yet again, should have taken that. I said last week that the inexperience of Richard Horn not being a natural winger. Does he overrun the man?
Well, I don't think the pass was crash hot myself.
Well, I thought it was okay. You've got to take them.
On halfway, Gower plays the ball. You've got to take half chances when Australia are in town.
But it's quite clear, and Great Britain know it, and David Waite, the coach, knows it, that they are vulnerable. The Australians out wide in the centre, and it looks like the big fella's coming into the fray.
Good kick, crossfield kick from Kamali. Oh, this is dangerous. Knocked all over the place, and Radlinski has it. But he was eventually hauled to ground. Here's Carney.
Oh, great defence. Solid.
Hold here.
This is Connolly.
On three.
Good work from Gower.
Good work by the English forwards. They've got to really work hard in that department. They've got to try and suck the Australians down the centre. We've already spoken about the fact that Great Britain can get the ball out wide.
Sculthorpe, damn kick. Radlinski's after this. Oh, and it's hacked forward. Radlinski's chasing the kick ahead by Deakin. Radlinski will score. Radlinski will score. He'll give it to Ian Orton again.
He wants to see if he's onside.
He'll just make sure he's onside.
That's what he wants to find out. No doubt about the grounding. Is he in front of the kicker? He's okay on that situation. It's from here now that it counts. Is he in front? Yes, he is. This will be no try. He's half a metre in front. There's not much in it, but I'm sad to say I'll be very surprised if this try is given. He's just a fraction in front. It looks as though he's going to be okay.
Well, for those of you who thought that Steve-O was the man who got Adrian Morley sent off last week.
Yeah, I've got
the
no
video proof. Referee does not listen to our commentary and our comments. And that's the reason why the try is given. Radlinski, his first try in 9 test matches against Australia. Chris Radlinski following the kick-up, and the try is given.
Both sides utilising the little kick over the top. Beautiful place there by Sculthorpe. Deacon just got the crash to it. He knew he couldn't get to the ball. Beautiful bounce. Radlinski in for the try again. Well weighted. It is causing all sorts of trouble for the Australian defence. They don't normally utilise a sweeper. And the result is a TRY. Great Britain take the lead yet again. What a game.
Yes, it has all the makings of a classic. And here is Deacon to try and add the extras, which he does. 12-8, Great Britain are ahead.
We spoke so often last week about the lack of the kicking game. No doubt in my mind, David Waite and the Great Britain squad, they've worked hard on just the short game, over the top. I mentioned the fact that Australia very rarely use a sweeper. They depend on the wingers dropping back late in the tackle count. And they've caught them out on a few occasions. Now then, composure. Get into a good position, then get a good kick away and make sure that the chase is solid.
Well, we are watching the British Lions, but they are playing with bulldog spirit. And that's Anderson. Oh, not the best pass. Bobbling and bouncing its way to Deacon. He nearly got under Michael de Vere.
Here it is.
Farrell, senior again.
Good play by Farrell. Opted to go into the dummy half, make sure to just calm things down a little bit. This is the point where we've got to just keep cool. Great Britain have to get a good kick away now. Will they go the option over the top again?
Yes, they will. And it's causing Australia all sorts of problems. Oh, he's lost that. And Britain have it back. Oh, now then, that's a shimozzle.
It's got to be a penalty.
Stolen. Ball stolen.
They'll take the two. Well, full credit to David Waite, the Great Britain coach. It is causing havoc. Obviously, Chris Anderson, on that occasion, he dropped back the sweeper. But the error was there. The pretty cool customer is David Waite. Holds a British passport. A lot of people don't realise that. And if there's one Australian here in this stadium tonight that wants the boys in red, white and blue to come away with a win, it is that man. He has worked tirelessly to try to wrest those ashes away from Australia's grasp. He may do it if they keep this up.
Lockyer, his team are judged to have stolen the ball in the tackle. And Deacon, well, that's why he's in the side. He has got a robotic right foot. 14-8.
And full credit to Paul Deacon. Remember the mistake right from the kickoff. Lesser players would have gone to water. They would have lacked the concentration.
He's Super League's leading point scorer in each of the last 3 seasons. And Australia hammer the ball out on the fall. Darren Lockyer. Penalty on halfway. Deacon again.
I'd shove it in the corner. Turn the screw at 14-8. Australia are wobbling. They haven't had possession for quite some time.
Midway through this first half. And Deacon will drill the ball to touch.
That's good thinking. Andy Farrell obviously got the message straight away. Let's just twist the tourniquet.
Here's Anderson.
That's the type of run we need. Great Britain have to keep looking for that.
Morley
into the fray. Look at him. He attracts the flies to them.
Well, he is the best forward in the world. The Aussies admit that. And here's one who's not far behind him. Stuart Fielden. Drilling the ball 10 metres away from the line. It's with Deacon. It goes wide. Big ball from Sculthorpe to Peacock. He keeps it going. Sculthorpe again.
Great tackle from Vadir, as it had to be as well. Neat little inside move.
Now then, Farrell will come back in the middle. Farrell!
great play from Lockyer, but what a great dummy from the skipper. Oh, it went backward. That'll be play on.
That won't be.
Oh, that is a shame.
The first one was backwards. The second one from Fielden went forward.
Quick glimpse there of Chris Anderson. He knows that a lot of nerves coming into it. He's got to try to organise their defence. He's already bought and sent out the message to make sure that Mansing, Minicello drop back, a little kick, and what a meal that is! What a meal that has become!
Sivanasiva just on. The Australians are rattled and Chris Anderson knows it.
Sivanasiva fails to be the receiver. What an error, what a mistake. Lack of concentration yet again. We've got to put on a set move now. Will they work the blind side?
They come this way, and here is Senior. Senior trying to step his way through as he did last week. Hall down. First tackle, we're 3 metres short of the line, Great Britain. Sculthorpe, back it goes to Deacon. Movement all over the park. Great ball.
Yet another error from the Australians. This occasion, the substitute, Sivanasiva, spilled the ball, and from this position, Great Britain in a confident mood, using the dummy runners yet again. Big fella Anderson. Look at the ease that Connolly did that. They came out of the line, and as soon as they were sucked in, what wonderful play by the centre. Got all the experience in the world. Watch how he just shapes the body. Great pass from Anderson. Oh, Gower took it. And he went over for the four. We're on a roll. Great Britain. Listen to the crowd here.
Well, he's waited a long, long time for that moment. He was doubtful all week after being injured in the first test at Wigan. What a night to come up with your first international try for Great Britain. Now Deacon, can he add the extra two? Oh, yes he can! 20 points to 8.
Good work from the forwards, sucked in the Australian defence. Look at the open space there. There's only Gower that's going to stop him. And watch how he just throws the dummy back on the inside. Lockie went far too high.
Deep kickoff, Anderson, who has caused problems since the moment he stepped over the whitewash. The second Think Road safety test is swinging Britain's way at the moment. 20 points to 8, long time to go, Sean.
Yeah, it is, Eddie, but games are won, certainly by territory, field position and possessions, and then taking your opportunities. And so far in 25 minutes, that's what Great Britain have done. They've starved Australia of possession, they've starved them of opportunities, and of course they've forced one or two errors, and there's been some unforced errors. Darren Lockyer kicking out on the full. The kicking game by Great Britain up until that kick has been superb, and the short kicking game has caused a lot of problems for the wingers and the fullback. They're actually making them come to the ball rather than getting the ball to the player, which is something they did in the first test, and I think that the back three returned the ball so well and so easily against Great Britain. An obvious change of tactic tonight, which has worked very well. It's upset the defensive pattern of the Australian side. And so far, it's paying magnificent dividends. Great Britain 20, thoroughly deserved. Australia needs some football. They need some possessions. They really haven't settled down to this game yet. And it's not quite catch-up time yet. A lot of patient players out there and players that have been in this position before. But it is worrying signs for them and something that they're going to have to address very, very quickly.
Sean, the biggest problem I can see from the Australian point of view in their defensive lineup, they don't know whether it's going to be they're expecting the deep kick. But Great Britain, to their credit, they're doing the little short over the top and they're not having the sweeper there.
Yeah, it's a great tactic, Steve. And of course, most sides now don't play a sweeper. Most sides will play the halfback or the standoff up in the line and play that extra man there. Darren Lockyer possibly may be forced to play a little bit shorter, or maybe one of the wingers go a fraction deeper and Darren Lockyer have a more sort of roving commission. But it's something they're going to have to address because it's really worried them. I wouldn't be surprised, you know, Steve-O, if David Waite sends a message out saying, we'll now start to kick deep. We'll change the tactic completely and we'll start kicking deep, and that might throw them off completely.
Well, the Australians have got some territory here now. That's four tackles gone. They're 8 metres away from the line. And this is a little dart here from Danny Badiris. And the British defence stands firm for five. Can they hold on for the last? They're all stood offside there. And there's the kick from Kimoli again. Off the post, and Radlinski was alert to it. And he did well.
Bobbled all over the place.
Kimoli's a magician with the boot.
Neat little kick there. Not out of my mind that he was actually aiming for that ball. Looked to be as he was taken out of the action after he's kicked the ball, not seen by any official. But good work from the fullback Radlinski. Kept a watchful eye on the ball. But I must say that it appeared to me that Kimoli was taken out pretty late.
High drop out from Deacon. It bounces a little unkindly for Gower. It gives Great Britain a second or two more vitally to get up onto him and close him down. It's the second goal line dropout the Aussies have forced. Sivanasiva bounces off one. Good job that Skelthorpe was there.
He wasn't tackled initially.
And here is Fitzgibbon now for the Aussies.
On three.
We'll say good credit to the referee, Tim Manor, the Australian. He's giving them plenty of space, making sure both sides can play attractive football.
And Rickardson puts the ball down, and the referee will put the scrum down because there is no advantage to Great Britain.
Big hit from Morley as well. Boom. Put their pressure on. That's what's needed. Morley went first and then certainly got to him, the captain. And I go along with Sean McRae is that if we change the tactics now, it's a good moment to make sure we get good roll forward with the men from the pack and then get a good kick and chase. Make sure that they put Australia way back in their own territory. The biggest problem, though, the Australians are so good at the counter-attack from way down within their own quarter.
That was a dart from Carney on the fourth. There's Connolly. And here is Farrell. Farrell shaping to kick and then getting over halfway. Under pressure from three, Rickardson and Webke. And De Veer, who's now back in the defensive line. And there is Deacon's kick down the line. And that's a beauty. Well, he was brought in to sort the kicking game out, and so far, mission accomplished.
Certainly has, and how important. The point that I was making is that to make the advantage and get over the halfway line, five drives, the good solid kick. To keep Australia down here, this is where we've got to really concentrate. Great Britain cannot relax here. Remember, it was Wing that made the break from deep within their own quarter. That proved the match winner when Lockie went over for the try.
That's Minicello who takes the first tackle. That was Kimoli. He feeds it wide to Webke. Oh, and that's dangerous.
Well, he called held. Referee. A few words with Andy Farrell. They say, well, we never heard it.
No, it's the fact that the legs went up in the air like that.
Well, you're not allowed to put the arm in between. And certainly Skelthorpe did that.
So it has gifted the Australians about 20, 30 metres further upfield. Two penalties apiece in this second Think Road Safety Test match. And it's Fitzgibbon, and he gets the ball away, having attracted two. And this is Gower, and Britain have to watch him as well. And they strike into the ground eventually in the shape of Morley. Here's Kimoli. Back it goes to the substitute that was Waterhouse. He gets it away to Craig Wing. And the Aussies are 10 metres away. And Senior in for the kill.
Good push there by Stuart Fielding. Couldn't get to the tackle, but make sure he put the hooker to the ground. The
dearest to De Veer. De Veer then onto Kimoli. There's Lockyer. It's another great kick. And Carney takes no chances.
Did the right thing. Again, we see the importance of the short kicking game. Lockyer obviously taking that responsibility now on the Australian side. You'd normally get that from Brett Kimoli. That gives me some indication that we knew Kimoli was going into this game with an injury problem. They're obviously trying to take the responsibility of the kicking game away. Darren Lockyer no stranger to that department, but I must say that this Great Britain side, they look stronger. They're taking control in the forwards. That's always a good sign.
Well, that's a poor kick, though, to Lockyer. Lockyer tips it inside. And here comes Webke, who bounces off two. And Andrew Farrell, you're talking about injured players. Farrell there in the tackle, but he was struggling to get back in the defensive line for the last Australian wave. Maybe the continuing knee problem is blighting the captain. Oh, and there's a half break on there, and that was a good job. Britain got a hand to that.
Yeah, with a knock on, head and feel to the Kangaroos. There's a skipper talking to Stuart Fielden.
He's knocked the ball that way, and the blood's come from behind.
No doubt about it that the winger, Richard Horn, got fingertips to that.
Good job he did. And Deakin actually looked as though he might have been standing in front. It could have been worse. Could have been a penalty. As it is, it's head and feet to the Aussies. Here's Gower. Farrell with a great tackle. If he is on one leg, he's a hero. Oh, well, now then. Second quick
this will be interesting.
Against Great Britain.
I think they'll take the quick tap.
And they have. Here they come with Kimoli. Back on the inside to Sivanasiva.
They know 2 points is no good at this point in time. They want to get 6 points before half-time if they can.
Fitzgibbon.
Great defence. Farrell standing like a mountain.
And Peacock. Kimoli. Britain try to close him down. He gets the ball away again, though, to Lockyer. And hounding tackling by Deakin Senior. And also Adrian Morley. Ball is lost. Oh, penalty.
Well, you pay the price, Eddie, if you're going to do those tactics. That's when the man hits the ground, you try to turtle him, turn him over.
You wave at
it's a great ploy if you can get away with it.
They do that every week in Australia.
I know that.
We've got an Australian referee.
That's why he's penalised it.
Three in a row against Great Britain, Sivanasiva.
And two.
Badiris is the man we've got to keep an eye out.
And so is this fellow Kimoli back on the inside.
Oh,
Webke.
That look forward. That'll be the knock-on.
Another knock-on against Great Britain. More territory coming for Chris Anderson and Australia.
Chris Anderson knows that they've got to get over that whitewash.
They're beautiful.
They're putting their bodies on the line there. No doubt. Keith Senior got a hand to that. That look forward. It was delayed by Kimoli.
It's a formation.
And it looked as though Lockyer would have gone over there if it wasn't for the intercept and the knockdown from this fella.
Next time we'll just play it. That's your warning.
Well, another big test of the Great Britain defence. Kimoli to Gower. Oh, and Gower slips. Morley comes in to finish him off. Farrell, rather, comes in to finish him off. This is Fitzgibbon. Can the British defence stand firm? 5.5 minutes to half-time. Badiris waits. Here's Kimoli. There is Webke. Webke dumps the ball down. That's flicked back. Play on. Britain have it back. They have survived.
Suicide pass. Far too impetuous, trying to keep the ball alive. Bang it straight through. Crowd getting a little bit upset at the fact that Tim Mander, the Australian referee, look at that. Impossible situation. Scunthorpe was always in the face. He was all going to get the ball first.
Here goes Connolly.
Wait for you.
Newton waits at dummy half.
That's a way to do it. Just calm it down.
Mike Forshaw, who ran his blood to water last week, replaces Paul Anderson. Deakin with a big kick downfield. And he will look to turn Minicello round, which he has done. And Richard Horn, well, he halted him momentarily, but then he gets the ball away to Lockyer, and Lockyer up the middle.
Great chase, though, by Great Britain. They did well there.
Important tackle by Fielden.
The one thing you cannot do is put the ball right down the throat of Darren Lockyer. And apart from only two occasions in this first half, Great Britain have done that.
He's holding.
Inside the last five of this first half, a 12-point lead for Great Britain.
And it's important that we keep it that way.
Here comes the substitute. Waterhouse gets the ball away. They're so dangerous as they come up the middle. There is a man in support here. Oh, that kick's charged down. Oh, it's bounced back into the arms of Kimoli. The green and gold's flooding forward with Gower. They have a man wide. And it is Fitzgibbon who... Now then,
I think that
was wrestled away from him by Scunthorpe. Eyes not good to the video.
Well, I can't believe that. It bobbled all over the place.
It was a certain try, but just as the ball was being placed down, did Fitzgibbon lose it?
Certainly appeared that way. Good effort by Scunthorpe. No, that's fine.
I'm not so sure.
No, he had the compact, the control of the ball. Right at the end of the ball, hits to it.
25,000 at the KC Stadium, don't agree.
It's on the board, it's fish and chips in the papers tomorrow, don't worry about that. How many times have I been saying that this Australian side will come through? It wasn't a good option from Badiris. He really should have made sure that he took possession. But good play. They're all at sea. Scunthorpe tried his best. Carney had to be sucked through. Not surprising when they make a clean break. But the times that the green and golds do this in test matches. There it is. That's no problem.
Well, the elbow was down, but the ball wasn't, and it bobbled.
No, that was a try, Eddie.
Listen to the crowd. They don't agree with you.
They don't have the whistle. I don't want it to be a try any more than you do, don't worry. But you've got to be fair, and that was a fair try.
Fitzgibbon has missed it. His try, he doesn't convert it. It's 20 points to 12. We all want to be first, Devo. There's no question of that. But there was an element of doubt, and I just question why Tim Mander didn't go to the video referee. There was an element of doubt about Brian Carney's try last week. We said no try. The video referee said otherwise.
Well, we haven't seen much attacking play from the Australian hooker, Danny Badiris, but we saw the quality and class came out there. All right, he got the benefit. Wasn't the best attempt at the kick, ricocheted away, and the rest is history. 4 points on the board. What a game this is turning out to be.
Indeed, and I hope belatedly we welcome our viewers in Australia on Channel 9, who are all no doubt up early in the morning and celebrating one Australian victory yesterday, and they're probably screaming at these two very biased Poms that they're listening to right now.
That's four.
But 20 points to 12, Great Britain lead. Oh, lovely kick from Kim Morley. The man's a genius. And it's a fortunate thing that Craig Wing could not take that pass in. Kim Morley, though, is magnificent.
Super kick up at the top, isn't he? Got a great box of tricks, this fella. He should have taken that, Craig Wing.
There is a medal, Steve, that's been struck by the Rugby Football League to commemorate Alan Prescott, the late great British Lion. And that will go to the man of the series. And at the moment, Brett Kim Morley is on his way to winning it. But this is Mike Forshaw.
Well, we're midway through the series. A few seconds remaining.
Drop goal attempt from Farrell. Has it got the legs? No, just underneath the bar.
Not a bad option, though.
No, because he knows there'll be no time to restart this match. And Britain will have an 8-point lead at the half-time siren. David Waite makes his way down with Brian Noble to greet Paul Scunthorpe and company. And Britain are 40 minutes away from levelling up the series. third test in the series is next Saturday. It's live only on Sky Sports 1 from 6. And will that third test be the decider? Well, if we stop now, it would be. Great Britain are ahead, 20 points to 12. They've run in 3 tries to 2, and Deakin has kicked 4 goals successfully. 20 points to 12 at half-time. And the British, relaxing, if that be the right word, in their dressing room, know that it's one of the best first halves that the Lions have had against the Kangaroos in recent memory. 22-0, Melbourne, 1992. We'll never forget that night. 12-0, Huddersfield, 2 years ago in the first test. It's up there with the best. And David Waite now hopes that this speech will create the momentum to go forward and pick up the spoils in the second 40 minutes. The British coach is animated. Well, he might be. Just down the corridor in the Australian dressing room, Chris Anderson, trying to rally his troops, knows that they are in a real battle, and Great Britain have taken it to them. They trailed, remember, Great Britain 2-0, conceding the penalty early, but they fought back, and there has been real bulldog spirit on show by Great Britain here in front of a packed house at the KC Communication Stadium in Hull. Terrific night so far, but can Great Britain now push on and win this second test? Can they?
Yeah, of course they can. It's good, isn't it? Great, especially if they're a pommy. But full credit to the Australians. They put us under pressure right at the start. But the Great Britain side, they've taken control. A lot more aggression in the forwards. A lot better than what the Australians have thrown at them. If there's any danger, it's going to be out in the three quarters. We got off to a poor start. The mistake by Deakin, it went backwards. Then we got away with that. Farrell very, very slow to get the kick away. Luckily, we did not concede a try. And it was the beautiful mistake from Gower. I know I shouldn't say that, but lack of communication between the two Australians. And from that scrum, look at the pass from Morley. This will go down in the history of Ashes series as one of the great passes. I think it even surprised Adrian himself. Newton in for the try. Then there was a no try. Deakin just got there before Fitzgibbon did. Oh, very close indeed, under pressure. Kicking game from both sides at that time. Superb. And it was a kick yet again from this man, Kamali. He's outstanding. Lockyer knew exactly where it was going to him. Then the kick through yet again. And just a little bit too late there. Got very, very close indeed. Just on the whitewash. Every man in this stadium and woman, and the pass from Fielder, they lifted. Deakin did the right thing. Make sure you keep possession. That is something that you must do. And from that, they came through with yet another superb play. Look at the kick over the top. All right, a little bit of luck here. The kick ricocheted. And Radlinski in for the try there. Maybe a hint that he was just in front. Video referee said that. Sivanasiva came up with a really bad error. That's the second one near their own line. Remember, Gower conceded the try. And it wasn't surprising. You could see there that the Australian defence, Connolly, just threw the dummy. There was no way they were going to stop him. And when we just thought that we were in control of this game, it was the Badiris break that put them in this position. And Eddie said that he'd lost the football over there, but sadly, I would have to disagree with that. He appeared to get the ball down and then lost it. We've still got a long way to go. Great Britain really have to keep their concentration for the next 40 minutes. They cannot rest. The defence is good. The forwards have laid the platform. The little kick over the top, it's been a master move, hasn't it, to put Paul Deakin out there to start this game, and he has showed his coach what he can do.
Yes, terrific. But, you know, I will come back to that last try from Craig Fitzgibbon again and again. The referee went for 2 other would-be tries for Australia. One that was over the whitewash in the in-goal area. One for Fitzgibbon where he was stretching for a kick through. Why didn't he just at least ask Ian Ollerton to take a look at that last Craig Fitzgibbon try? Sean McRae, I will ask the question of you. should that have been handed on to the video referee? Because I'm convinced that was a bobble as the ball was put down.
I think there's enough doubt there, Eddie, and I think that's if the referee has that facility and, you know, he's been to the screen already tonight on a number of occasions, why not ask? It's time off. It's not going to take any more time up in the game, and I can't see any reason why not. Obviously, he's got an all clear from the touch judges. He was happier with it. I think there's an element of doubt, but I think the try probably would have been given. So, but I still agree with you, Eddie, which is pretty normal anyway. I just think the ball goes down here. There's downward pressure there. Then it appears to come loose. I think the try would have been given, but I certainly would have gone and asked about it. That's for sure.
10, 15 minutes, absolutely crucial at the start of this second half. Great Britain are ahead, but by 8 points, and the biggest 40 minutes of the year is coming up after this break. Kingston Communications Stadium in the city of Hull, staging the second test between Great Britain and Australia. Britain ahead at half-time, 20 points to 12. The Think Road Safety Test Series alive and kicking. And what a fillip for those England players watching in their hotel in Lancashire this evening, ahead of tomorrow's European Nations Cup final in Warrington against the French. Another match you'll be able to see live with us on Sky Sports. But all thoughts right now well and truly on the second 40 minutes. And I said, Steve-O, as we hit the break, these British players now face the biggest 40 minutes of their season. It's the biggest 40 minutes of the year. Hey, it's the biggest 40 minutes of their lives.
No doubt about that. Very rare that I agree with you on every point.
Well, you talked about try scored.
Don't bring that up. It's already on the scoreboard. And that is something that we have to put to one side. We've got to be positive. We cannot just hang back and think that we can rest on this 8-point lead. We can't.
Down there he is.
I've said that
the Australians by attacking them.
Yes, you've got to. You've got to keep applying that pressure that we did in the first 40. Look, Chris Anderson realises that the forwards are not working as a unit. They're not being as aggressive. They're not getting over the advantage line. And in therefore, they're not giving the opportunities for the three-quarter line. He'll have been working on that in the half-time break. They will be trying to keep this ball alive, and they'll make sure that the forwards work hard. But at this point in time, Great Britain, they're winning in all departments.
And Kevin Sinfield is on at the start of this second half. Great kick-off underneath it, Craig Wing. Good chase from Great Britain as well. Matt Singh is the dummy half. Into centre field, enveloped by Barry McDermott and Stuart Fielden. This is Fitzgibbon. Great Britain know the danger of Fitzgibbon and Kim Morley and Lockyer. Medeiros, not a bad player either. There is Kim Morley, the kick downfield. And it's straight into the arms of Chris Radlinski on the bounce. Britain will counter, launch the first attack of their first, of their second half. Let's go down to the side. Half-time news, Chris with the Aussies, Bill with the Brits.
Eddie, two key areas for Great Britain as far as coach David Waite is concerned. They've got to tighten up on the mark of defence where the Australians have found one or two gaps in that first 40 minutes, and they've got to try and bottle up some of these offloads that have also caused them a lot of damage. Those are two areas they're going to be targeting. Kicking game, very impressed with, and they want to maintain that. And they also know the opening 10, 15 minutes of this second half are crucial to Great Britain's prospects in this Ashes series. Let's hear the Australian viewpoint, Chris.
Well, the word from the Australian camp, as you'd expect, is all about composure and patience. They did it last week, and it took some brilliance from Craig Wing and Lockyer to get them out of trouble. They'll be hoping for the same here tonight. On the injury front, all is fine. A lot different to last week at the JJB. This time last week, about three or four thought they were in Disneyland. But the word is composure and patience. They know they've got the ability to get themselves out of trouble, but they must pick up their completion rate. They are a little bit concerned. They know that there's talent in the Great Britain kicking ranks, particularly in the short kicking game, so all eyes are on Paul Deacon.
Steve-O, the first kick from Paul Deacon, straight down the throat of Darren Lockyer. Oh, that's a big hit. That's a great offload to Willie Mason. But is it just the fact that Lockyer is such a great fullback that for every kick downfield, he seems to be in exactly the right position at exactly the right time?
Well, it wasn't the best kick. I must say that you've got to make sure you turn them around because he's got so much speed. You have to split. You've got to get the ball in that area where both the winger and the fullback are converging at the same time. Maybe they can come up with an error. Maybe if he'd applied the pressure. They've got to get it right.
There's Kevin Sinfield, first touch of the Test Series for him. New five-year deal with the Leeds Rhinos, safely locked away. And this now is Senior, his Leeds teammate. Sinfield in at dummy half. Now Barry McDermott, Leeds trio there. McDermott gets Great Britain to halfway on the last. Sinfield again. Back it goes to Deacon. Deacon will drill the kick downfield. This time it bobbles a couple of times before it's picked up by Minicello. Minicello coming across field. Great hit by Connolly.
Not only did the tackle, spun him around, drove him into the ground.
Mateo, let it go, let it go.
Lockyer gets the ball away to Fitzgibbon. Fitzgibbon offloads to Lockyer. Ball went backwards, play on. Here is Gower. Here is Lockyer. Dancing little run again.
Well, that's good defence.
And it was Minicello.
They kept their ground there, Great Britain. Didn't panic.
White.
Medeiros. Infielder comes again. Oh, that's another big hit.
That's four. Roll on.
Two players out wide, Great Britain are forcing. They're just squeezing the Australians. Oh, they've got away with it again.
They have, and this is Lockyer. Oh, Lockyer has slipped the net once more. He's got players out wide and inside him. And that ball is lost, and it's play on, and Webke is trapped.
Crowd don't like it. Referee's got it spot on.
Medeiros. Gower. Kim Orley again. And Richard Horn just shuttles the ball dead. And the crowd on the back of the referee, Tim Mander.
Well, very fortunate play. Very scrappy indeed. And the Kangaroos got away with it so many times.
But Kim Morley creates so much.
Certainly does. And they went far too high on this fella. Good support play. But we got back exceptionally well. Inchello knew he couldn't go any further. They're booing the official. But he got his spot on. Just a little bit of a fumble there from Richard Horn.
Drop out from underneath the British sticks again then. Has to be a good one. It's on the bounce to Lockyer. He then tips it infield again to Shane Webke. And that's a big hit by Morley. Totally legal. 30 metres away. The Aussies. Fitzgibbon. Gower. And Gower. Clattered by Paul Sculthorpe. Here now is Craig Wing. Morley. Great harassing. Medeiros, they've come down the short side, then they switch the direction to Lockyer. And Kim Orley, again the ball, oh well, I was about to say again the ball went backwards and Mr. Mander gets a standing ovation from 25,000 in Hull.
Well, I think we got the benefit of the doubt there, but he just bobbled in front. Remember, you knock on, it was good work there by Barry McDermott. And once you have the ball dislodged, have to hit the ground. As soon as it moves and hits the opposition, it's got to be deemed a
tackle one, let it go.
A knock on.
Look.
Deacon, the dummy half. Farrell, they close him down so quickly.
A lot more pressure being applied now by the Australian forwards. Really, in the first half, there was only Shane Webke that really came to the fore and was taking it to the Great Britain side.
Sinfield, McDermott. Needs another big 20 minutes or so from Barry McDermott. David Waite. Sinfield. Fielder. Big hit by Willie Mason. That's great defence from the Aussies. Sinfield. Foul. High kick. Oh, it's out on the full. He holds his head in his hands. And Adrian Morley comes to the sideline.
Well, disappointed, the Great Britain captain, but...
So is his coach.
Yeah, but really... He shouldn't show that sort of emotion, you know, get on with it.
This is De Vere.
Don't give the opposition any inkling that you perhaps are not getting things right.
Willie Mason.
Now it's Australia, they're getting across that advantage line. That's what they lacked in the first half.
Medeiros, Kim Morley again. Kim Morley! Magnificent. Absolutely magnificent. Brett Kim Morley. He has got so much faith in his ability. And he is producing it on this tour. His pass created Gower's try last week. He was man of the match in 1999. In the win for Melbourne in the World Cup Club Championship, and it all came about as a result of that shocking kick from Andy Farrell.
Not only that, the body language was poor, communication in the defensive line was even worse, but full credit to Kamali. I offered this guy after they thrashed Wales a couple of weeks ago, I said I'd pay for his trip to Lanzarote for 3 weeks, all expenses paid. I wish he'd have accepted my offer. He has been superb.
A real thorn in the side. And Fitzgibbon now to add the extras. And that is academic. He missed one for the first time on this tour in the first half. But he's added the extras here, and the gap now is down to two. Australia fighting back. And there is the man from Cronulla via Melbourne. Hunter Mariners. Remember him in the 97 Super League World Club Championship. Brett Kimmorley announced his appearance on the international stage then. This is his 16th cap tonight, and that was a wonderful individual try.
Just getting back to that body language by Andy Farrell. At a time like that, we all make mistakes, but it's up to a skipper to be able to just say and turn around and say, OK, come on, fellas. You've got to lift each other. You've got to work as a unit. They've done that
Carney
so far.
Carney is appealing there that Willie Mason lost that ball in the tackle. It was a desperate appeal to the referee and touch judge.
It certainly,
had none of it.
Certainly bobbled, didn't it? Oh, he did well to squeeze on that.
Better defence for Britain here.
He's working really hard, isn't he? Andy Farrell knows that he came up with that error.
Kick from Lockyer, straight down the throat of Radlinski. Now can Radlinski counter for the British?
One. There it is, hold here, hold!
Doesn't seem as much zip in the British play at the moment. Carney.
Complete reversal of one, the first half. Australia looked far more keen and their defence is solid. That's a good hit there from Mason.
Great hit from Willie Mason. This is Peacock.
We've got to still be adventurous.
Sinfield, Scunthorpe.
We've got to try the little short kick, which was so effective in the first stanza.
This is the last. Here's the kick from Deakin. It's out wide, but it's straight up in the air almost. Horn is after it. Tackle's completed.
Well, he tried to get away with it. The whole three-quarter, Richard Horn. Took it well.
Ball carrying arm had hit the deck before he got rid of it. Australia coming strongly in the opening 10-15 minutes of this second half, as we feared they might. That's a great hit from Fielden. That will lift Great Britain. Waterhouse felt that.
That's the sort of body language that Great Britain need. It's an important 10 minutes now for the GB boys.
Kevin, sorry.
They cannot afford to allow Australia to take the lead.
Kimmorley again. Sinfield gets to him with Farrell this time.
Again, try to turn him. At least they have slowed down the quick play of the ball.
That's a knock-on.
Play on.
Here is Anderson, but Gower was right in his face.
That header was forced. They really got into the faces there, Great Britain.
Carney, they're alert to his danger after his two tries last week on his debut.
Good work, though, by the winger. Taking the pressure off the forwards. Again, we see Farrell working out wide in the centres.
Denny!
Might be a bit of a ploy if David Waite brings him a little bit closer to the first, second receiver.
Good hands from Great Britain, but Peacock runs into a brick wall.
Good tackle by Gower, going down low.
Here's Deakin. Now Scunthorpe. And it's Radlinski! Radlinski makes the break! Carney! That's a mile and a half forward.
Well, he knew he was going for the whitewash. This is definitely no try. The tap on the 22. Radlinski causing all sorts of problems there. Has been a problem in this Australian three-quarter line.
Again, the pass to the winger just behind him.
Yeah.
He had to reach back for it, Carney.
But it was a panic.
Hands out!
But it just shows you the problems that Australia do have in that centre position. They've been caught out so many times.
It's tight as a drum, isn't it? It really is. This is Badiris. Here is Fitzgibbon.
It's up to the forwards now. Who is going to take control of this game? This is a tough moment when you've got to dig deep.
Kimmorley.
That's four. Roll out, roll it!
Good tackle on Simpson. Over the halfway line of the Aussies. Kimoli. Oh, there's the little dab over the top. He saw the space. It's bounced perfectly. That's a good tackle. That's a great tackle from Radlinski. But here they come with Lockyer. And Lockyer looking for Gower. Carney's there. And Carney will run it dead. Another goal line dropout coming up.
Beautiful chip over the top, Kimoli. David Wade fully aware of the dangers. Good thinking, though, by Brian Carney, the Irishman.
The crowd trying to rise and rally Great Britain here.
Well, it's a good job that Steve Simpson overrun the support play, but again, a little dink forward by the fullback Darren Lockyer. Apply the pressure.
Lockyer just been checked out, though, by the Aussie physio on the run. Anderson just watching from the sideline as this goal line dropout eventually will take place.
And he knows, as Anderson, that if he can get consecutive sets of six, that doesn't matter what and how good your defence is, you apply that pressure, you will eventually just break them down.
Here's Robbie Kearns. That's great chasing and harassing, though, by Anderson and Fielden.
Fielden has tackled his heart out tonight.
Sivana Siva. He was missed by the first, but Sinfield stuck to him like glue. Badiris. He's got Rickardson with him.
We're not as eager getting into the faces. We're allowing them to run from the dummy half position.
Badiris again, another scoot. This is Gower. Then he gets it away to Wing. And Wing trying to go between the two of them, standing still.
That's four.
Couldn't get the pass away.
Keith.
Badiris once more. Kimoli. Kearns. Halted.
Okay,
on
one.
The last.
No
11 metres away from the line.
No, Australians doing the Look inside pass very, very well. They're running the angles at the Cole moment.
Kimoli.
Oh, that was a big let off there from Great Britain.
Yes, and he's knocked.
They were bobbling around all over the place.
The scrum.
The big fella.
He's out of here, knocked back.
Paul
and
Anderson.
Then Australia's knocked it on to scrum feed this way.
Scrum feed to Great Britain. That was a get out of jail card that Britain played.
Was it ever? Good dummy, and there you see, came off the feet of Farrell. Anderson scooped onto it, and that would have been play on.
Yeah, okay, got it.
And I'm just looking at the body language now with the Great Britain lads. A lot of them appear to be tired.
Roll in.
Andy Farrell especially, and Fielden, they've put an immense amount of work, not only with the ball, but their defensive quality. Let's hope that we're not going to capitulate yet again late in this game.
Oh, that ball is lost. Went backwards. No, play on.
Knock on.
No, knock on.
A few of the players now starting to question the official.
Straight down initially.
Tim Mander. Put that to one side. You've got to start digging deep. About it, he lost control of it. In a very dangerous position.
Who was it? Who?
Tense times for David Waite.
And he was pleading from the sideline there. It went backwards.
Derry!
But this is a mini crisis for Great Britain. Lockyer. He almost skipped inside. Sculthorpe, who eventually spun him to the ground. Quick play the ball. And that's Peacock trying to get Wing down.
First and second markers, Great Britain not working hard.
Badiris off the deck. This is Kearns.
Watch for the inside pass from Kimoli.
Let it go.
Will Lockyer be on the inside of this?
Badiris waits. Here's Kimoli. Back it comes. A drive forward.
Hands out.
Badiris again. Kimoli once more. Kimoli! They're standing off it. Eventually they haul him down. Last one.
Wonderful defence there. How on earth did they stop Kimoli scoring? Took a huge gamble, came off the whitewash. This was try time if he never got to that. Lockyer couldn't see him coming. It paid off. Crowd screaming for Tim Mander to penalise the Australians for offside.
Connolly drives it forward a bit more. Carney, Deacon, long pass. Plucked out of the air by Farrell. He gives it then to Senior. That Richard Hall.
That was try time. De Beer just got a hand to the leg.
Britain are taking the chance. Sinfield with a kick to the corner. There's no Carney though. Lockyer's going to have to run it back. And a
Now there wasn't a hint of obstruction there. Oh, got out of the way. It looked as though they were going to help him there. Matt Singh went to the rescue, but yet again, couldn't. Now then, Locker gets through. This is wonderful stuff. That will lift him. We talk about the body language, talk about it, the fatigue effort coming into it, and it will. But Brian Carney, on his debut last week, two tries. He didn't score there, but equally has applied the pressure. We talk about the consecutive sets and plays of six. And little wonder that Lockie has taken his time with the dropout.
The kick arrives on the bounce to Radlinski, who drives it into the chest of Craig Wing.
The thing that's impressing me is the way that Great Britain are wanting to keep this ball alive. They know that 2 points is not going to be sufficient.
Infield, Anderson drives it at Sivanasiva, and the Australian prop forward stood his ground. Sinfield again. Here is Deakin with space. It's with Farrell. It's with Senior. And he's a handful to put down. Richard Hall on home ground. Last one for Great Britain. What have they got in the locker? It's with Deakin. They want the kick wide. It's come this way. But it bounced into touch.
They were all at sea, not a bad option as well. Made sure that they were deep enough away.
I think Carney thought that Connolly was going, and Connolly thought Carney would have it.
Well, I must say, Matt Singh, it wasn't the greatest effort. He was all at sea. Amazing, isn't it? You get so confused. Wing Singh, and like a Chinese takeaway, isn't it?
59 minutes of the match gone. Kim Morley feeds the scrum, gets it away to Matt Singh.
Roll out.
Scott with the tackle. Kim Morley again. Sivanasiva. Big hit by Farrell and Anderson.
Let it go. Now he's leaning on it.
Badiris goes right. Forshaw and Senior hunting the man in possession. And it was Simpson. This is Crocker.
They've regrouped. Great Britain have done well. They look as though fatigue was trying to set in, but they've regrouped. They've got the defences line, especially the second marker out wide, and they're applying the pressure. They've done it well there.
And Kimoli's kick straight down the throat of Radlinski. Here is Brian Carney, who saw a gap and went for it. Oh, and he's got away from them. Fitzgibbon picked it up and dumped him. His legs were up in the air then. Sean, it's a vital time for Britain. Well, we can't hear Sean McRae at the moment. Back to him in a moment. This, meanwhile, is Anderson. Sinfield. Peacock.
Four.
Sinfield in at dummy half again. To Deakin. And Deakin attacking the line. Showing it. It opens up for Deakin. Oh! Desperate tackle from De Beer.
Beautiful play. He often gets criticised in the Super League season for not asking the question.
Farrell blows to Sinfield. Here is Peacock. Now Radlinski. Here is Connolly. Here goes Carney. Carney, oh, just short of the line.
Good power
Britain
play.
On the power play.
Well, it looks calm to David Wade. But he must have been disappointed. Oh, and that's a swinger yet again.
He got them for offside, Steve.
He got them offside straight away, but no doubt that Mr. Morley was very late. He'll give him a warning. He'd already given the penalty for offside.
You'll hit around the head, right?
And Adrian got a little bit excited, as he wants to be, and it was not the best yet again. Around about the same position of the field.
And he's put that on report. He has put that incident on report against Adrian Morley. And so the disciplinary committee have more to talk about with Morley. And that could be the end of his series.
I think you're right, Eddie. The Australians were pushing for Morley to be suspended for at least two or three games.
Well, I heard half a dozen. Badiris, Robbie Cairns.
I'm with you, Eddie. I think that could be a problem now.
Well, it depends how the disciplinary committee view it. Here's Fitzgibbon.
One, three, back up.
Well, three tackles no gone.
He may get away with the fact that the first contact may have been on the chest and the ball and
Kim
Morley
again.
First.
Ian, check tackle, mate. On four. Thank you.
Been a good effort by Kim Morley coming into this game.
He's got a problem
with an injury.
There, Craig Wing.
Brian Carney.
Kim Morley again.
Okay, one,
great tackle
up.
That time by Peacock. Last tackle for Australia. Here is Lockyer. He'll hoist the kick wide. They looked all offside out there. In touch, says the touch judge.
It's knocked on by Great Britain.
Oh, he's going to, he's going to give it a head and feed for Australia.
There's a knock on here.
Oh.
He's deemed it Richard Hall. Well, this is a big call. Well, I'm not so sure. I thought that Australia knocked it back. Whole fans out in plenty here.
Well, this is another big examination of the British defence. That looked a very, very tough call.
Certainly was.
Here's Crocker. Slips into the challenge of Forshaw.
Now you're hanging on.
Can't afford
you're
to give away
on.
A penalty.
He's still hanging on, Crocker. Badiris, Sivanasiva. Sivanasiva still.
No start.
Three tackles no gone. Badiris, Kim Morley, good ball back on the inside, Crocker, well done Field and Farrell.
Paul, wait!
Badiris waits again. Driving by Robbie Cairns.
Okay, last one.
That's the last one, he's lost it. He's lost that.
Well, that's all, that should have been a scrum down.
Instead, it could be a try. It's going to be a goal line dropout anyway. And how about that?
That was late as well. It's getting very tasty.
Well, it's all down to the man in the middle.
He's missed quite a few, but the most important fact is that Robbie Cairns has lost his football in the impact.
Never know nothing like this, man.
Loses control there, deliberately puts the ball down. Well,
now
then, haven't seen that.
I'm the referee.
How big is a pair of hands that big? I mean, it's just unbelievable.
I've just heard Andy Farrell ask the referees that have never seen anything like this. Every 50-50 is going their way. And I know that we'll be accused of bias,
but I agree. I couldn't believe what Cairns was doing. It's as though he was trying to put the ball over the try line. But fair credit to him.
He offloads again. Here's Lockyer. And Fielden just scrags the Australian captain to the ground.
They need to force the error.
They could do with a penalty. Sivanasiva.
One, two. Hands down.
Well, I thought for one moment there, Paul Sculthorpe had pinched the ball one-on-one. That's what we needed. And have a guess who he was running at. Adrian Morley had him lined up. Just had a little glance. Are you there, Adrian? Yes, I am. That is an enormous mistake. And the pressure is building not on the players out in the field of play, but Chris Anderson going through the horrors at the moment.
Radlinski. Britain needs something special here, because they are under the cosh.
Need a good effort by maybe the two wingers, Richard Hall, Brian Carney, moving quickly. Oh, what an error.
Yep. And it's going to be offside against Great Britain, and Australia have a kick here to level the test.
Oh, and again. All that pressure that we've turned away, very slow indeed, and this just about says it all.
Well, it's not often that David Waite loses his cool when he's watching a match, but he knows that Craig Fitzgibbon here has the chance to level the test.
Well, he knows, Eddie, and the sad thing about it is that Great Britain have controlled this game virtually throughout.
I don't want to go overboard about the penalty count, but I think Great Britain have had two, and one of them was for kicking the ball out on the full. bang in front, 30 metres away. This for 20 all. It's bounced over the top of the bar again. That's the second. That's the second that's hit the post and found its way over. They're riding their luck, the Aussies, but it's 20 all in this second Think Road Safety Test.
Well, they always say that the harder you work, the luckier you become, but that certainly is at the rub of the green tonight. Second occasion they've done that. Now then, Andy Farrell, Captain Courageous.
He was furious. He talked to the referee underneath the sticks. Well, every 50-50's gone against us, he said.
Give us a break.
Well, this huge crowd at the KC Stadium has to lift Britain now.
Not only that, the guys in red, white and blue, they've got to look at that badge on the left breast and say, we can do it. This is probably the most important 10 minutes of their playing career.
Badiris.
On three.
I don't think we've heard from Sean yet this half. Sean, this is a desperate time for Britain at the moment.
There it is, Eddie. I say bring out the one-point specialist. Obviously, Paul Deak and Andy Farrell, players like that that can kick the ball. From Australia's point of view, you've got Darren Lockyer, Brett Camorley, probably Craig Gowers, and there's plenty of guys out there capable of putting a one-point over. But, you know, with nearly 12 minutes on the clock, there's still plenty of time here to win a game or even lose a game. You know, it's been amazing tonight, Eddie, the number of kicks that have challenged other people, whether it's been a poor kick and the other team scored off it, or whether it's been a good kick and the attacking team has scored from that. It's amazing how many things have come from kicks tonight, and I'm sure we haven't seen the end of that.
Good move to bring Senior down the middle.
Here's Sculthorpe. Sculthorpe gets the ball away. Morley!
Looking for support. A little bit late. Second phase.
Sculthorpe, wide it goes. This is Fielden. And Australia forcing back. 10 metres away.
I'd be looking for the field goal. Drive to the six.
It's with Deacon. Here is Farrell. Now Keith Senior. And Connolly. Connolly can't get away from Craig Wing.
They've got to drive towards the sticks there. They've got Deacon. He's a one-point specialist. They've got to make sure they're in a good position.
Is the last one. Wait. They're not far away from the post now. It's back to Deacon. They knew he fancied it. They've gone wide, Britain, with Forshaw. Great defence. Great defence.
We should have gone for it, and David Waite knows it. With just over 10 minutes remaining, we should have put the nail in the coffin. We may regret that.
Here is Matt Singh.
Well, David Waite will be absolutely disgusted at the fact they've thrown that opportunity away. He's got to get the message out. If you get the other chance, another chance, you've got to go for it.
And I must say that if it stays at 20 points apiece, with the Australians winning the first test, they will retain the Ashes. That's brought a bit of silence. Sivanasiva, good defensive effort from Britain. So a one-pointer could be so, so vital. Kimorley, kick.
I know the Australians won't turn down the offer.
Well, now they look for the mistake from Radlinski and co. Gower leading the chase.
And I'm sure Great Britain realise all the players out in the field of play, they must be aware that a draw is not sufficient.
Carney.
It may be good for their ego and their pride, but it will not bring back what we want. That is the Ashes trophy.
And three.
59 was the last time we won on home soil, 1970.
Good offload by Forshaw. Morley nearly went without it. But the Australians now tackling like demons. Here's Deacon. And here's Sculthorpe. And wide it comes to Connolly. Connolly can't get away again. From Craig Wing. This is the last tackle.
We never played that right. We never played it at all, lost control of it. When really we needed to be able to put the pressure, that kick should have been done correctly. Loses it here. He's only himself to blame. There was no one applying the pressure. Unforced error.
Well, Australia now will try and roll forward into British territory and they could go for the one-pointer. Badiris. Fitzgibbon.
One, two. Run away!
Pretty far way out now.
Probably still haven't seen Sean Long tonight, have we? Mason. And Britain with four changes left.
Hands out, hands
and only
out.
8 minutes of the match remaining or thereabouts. Here's Kim Orley. Simpson is tackled by Newton. Quick play the ball, but dearest Kim Orley starting to come dangerously into it again as is Lockyer.
Oh,
fourth
back
knocked
to
down.
Six
to go. Kim Orley. And Morley gets to him.
Interesting to see where the Australians maybe just drive two to the sticks and go for the 1 point early.
Well, here's Willie Mason.
It'll be up the jumper time now.
Mike.
Will it be Kamali that takes it, or will it be Gower?
It's Webke. And Webke trying to run through Fielden. They're now 10 metres away.
Two.
That's the second tackle. They have plenty left. Vadiris, Willie Mason to drive it into the line. Mason.
And three.
They're a long way from the sticks. They're quite confident about getting over the whitewash.
Badiris inside to Kim Orley. Quickly closed down by Morley.
Back up. Here we go.
He wondered where it was. It was a number 12 British bus. This is Badiris.
Well, he's gone the wrong way. They've got away from the post.
Badiris, Kim Orley. Kim Orley dabs the ball over the top again. And Radlinski runs it back into the field of play.
Went down the blind alley. Surprised me that the Australians turned away the opportunity to go for that 1 point.
They need something special now, Great Britain.
Listen to this crowd. They're lifting them.
And
can
Senior provide it? He's got Hall outside him.
Should have looked for the winger. Will this be a penalty? No, Mander is turning to one side. Play on. Richard Horn takes it through. Can we get into a position? Wake will have got the message out. Great Britain player, I think it's Richard Orme that's down in back.
Senior.
Senior is it in back play.
That was Morley driving it in on the last.
It's a long way out. Will they opt for it?
They're trying to close Deacon down, so he comes wide to Sculthorpe. It comes further wide to Connolly. And the kick only finds its way to touch.
Well, at least they're in a good position to apply equal pressure, maybe just force the area, and that's what they're thinking about.
Great Britain need a break.
Yeah.
Senior has a problem with the right arm.
What's happening?
Let's not. That could be a bad one as well. You talk about break, Eddie. Let's hope that that is not a broken arm. He's in a lot of pain.
Don't break early, Mike.
Keith Senior.
And here is the winger, Max Singh. I'm right, aren't I? Sean Long has not been on the field yet.
Not yet.
Oh, the break is on. It's Rickardson who goes wide and finds De Veer.
Should have passed earlier. Rickardson there, the loose forward. Had De Veer. Maybe a split second early, they would have made the break.
Gower. Oh, great offload. And that's Minicello. They're bang in front of the sticks now. Will they go early? Kim Orley. Here's Willie Mason.
Four.
That's four, they're ever closer, 10 metres away.
Will they go early?
Kim Orley waits, he goes for the one-pointer. He's kicked it. Kim Orley edges Australia ahead.
You could have written the script. We should have been doing that 4 or 5 minutes earlier. They went early, they didn't wait until the last. And this man, Kim Orley, is becoming a nuisance.
Okay, yes.
Well, if they want to give the Alan Prescott medal to Man of the Series early, give it to Brett Kim Orley. It's gone short.
Knock back, that's fine.
Knock back and Crocker tidies up the danger for the Aussies. Great Britain need a miracle now, and they have conceded a penalty. The ashes are ebbing away.
And if we do lose this game, Eddie, we've only got ourselves to blame. We were not standing square at the play of the ball. We were out of the box far too early. And he'll be happy. The fans here, majority anyway, there's quite a lot of the Kangaroo supporters over for this match, quite a few tours.
And they'll be enjoying that 7-2 penalty count against Great Britain.
Well, Tim Mander won't be on the Christmas card list, that's for sure. But we cannot just blame the referee, Eddie, or any of that point. We had the opportunity, and we blew it. We didn't even go for it.
Oh. Well, He is now getting on everybody's nerves, including Jamie Peacock.
Straight out.
Well, it's one-on-one, but you could see
Sculthorpe
just had it out there.
Sculthorpe came in late.
It's a split second, just. Came in high as well. He's worked hard, though, Willie Mason. He's provided.
Tim Mander, the referee, and... and he is Long. Well, I'm sorry, 3.5 minutes to go. What can Long do? He'll have to produce a miracle. And he's going to come on, I think, for Keith Senior. But I don't think Senior wants to come off, but his arm looks in serious trouble.
Well, to be fair, David Waite wanted to back his choices, stay out there.
Well, the substitution, Steve, are a vital part of the game.
Yeah, but they are.
Fitzgibbon then with this penalty. If this lands, Britain have to score a try. They have to score a try.
Phenomenal, this fella. His style is so relaxed.
Stay up, Pastor.
Doesn't look as though he makes great contact, but boy, is he effective.
Senior comes up, Long still is not on. Senior's off, Long is still on the sideline. Britain.
Well, I thought he was in an off-fire position, but he can't because it came off a great Britain player. And I think we're clutching at straws now. The Australians will do nothing fancy. Well, it'll surprise me if they do. Less than 2 minutes remaining.
They might get another chance with the ball in hand, Great Britain. They might. Fitzgibbon.
One on one.
Play on.
We've got it.
Now then, last throw of the dice. Carney.
Oh, knees went in there. That should have been a penalty.
Deacon wide. Long is still not on the field.
That's who?
Well, it's a problem. If there's a problem with Senior, he's got to go out there. Surely Long is still waiting.
I think we've only got 12 men on the field, haven't we?
Three.
Yeah.
Oh, we have 13.
13.
We've got 13. But Long is stood there, waiting to come on.
Oh, I can't believe that.
That's it.
Yeah.
That is it.
Well, that's a shame. He's worked overtime, the second row, Jamie Peacock. And it is so disappointing. He'll be overjoyed, Chris Anderson. He said at half-time, don't panic. But you've got to...
They've kept Britain scoreless in the second half.
Yeah, you've got to look at two sections of the second half, Eddie.
Okay,
is it the skill factor of Kamali? He scores a try with a beautiful dummy and a shimmy through, and the field goal. But the most important factor... We turned down the offer for the 1 point. You can't afford to do it.
I think Deacon was very, very quickly shut down, Steve-O, as he tried to get that 1-pointer in. Badiris, he's lost that. Doesn't matter, though, because the sands of time are ebbing away.
Well, it's got to be a tap, kick and chase. That is the only thing.
He knows David Waite. The Great Britain have had the opportunities here to win this test.
Tap.
But the Ashes,
unless something
special comes up here, the Ashes are gone. The Ashes are gone.
Yep,
it's a 2-0 winning lead for Australia. A magnificent test match and a real backs-to-the-wall effort from this team from the Southern Hemisphere. They have lived up to all their expectations, and for Great Britain again, it is a question of what might have been. 2012, Great Britain led at half time. Kimorley with a try, Fitzgibbon with the boot, and crucially, Kimorley with the 1-pointer, making sure Australia take the Ashes home again. Test, the second test here at Hull, so near. And yet, so far again for Great Britain. Full house here, though, and needless to say, the magician from Australia, the little number 7, Brett Kimorley, has won the Man of the Match award. He's talking to Chris Warren.